See the screen. Today is the last class on complex numbers. Okay. We'll solve some problems. Okay, try this one. Getting it?
Yes.
Okay, what is the answer?
So just a second. B.
No, do it properly.
C.
No. Okay, we have to find this one, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
So this is magnitude of that one, which is equal to 1. You can distribute modulus operation, right? And modulus of conjugate is same as the modulus of the complex number.
Yeah.
Okay. And modulus of this is given as 1. So it is 1. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And then argument of this one is this plus this. And argument of conjugate is minus argument of z. And this is given as pi by 2. So it is minus pi by 2. So this is the point. The answer is A.
Okay.
Okay, try this question. I'll come. I'll just have a phone call.
Okay.
Is it easy? Hello? Your mic is off.
Hello?
Yeah, is it doable?
Yes, sir.
Or we can try some simple ones and come back to this later.
Okay, sir.
Okay, try this one. Getting the idea? This is equal to 0, right? 1 plus omega plus 1.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So this thing is minus omega. And this thing is 1 plus omega. This is equal to minus omega square. Omega cube is 1.
Okay.
So minus omega raised to the power n equal to minus omega square omega raised to the power n equal to omega raised to the power 2n. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So this thing will become this one.
Yeah.
On this, you have to get n equal to 3. Okay. So these two you have to use. Go to unity. Okay. This one. So this is minus 2. Getting it?
Yes, sir.
But this is an important step. When you take cube root on both the sides, minus 8 cube root is minus 2. And after that, you have to write this 181 raised to the power 1 by 3. Okay? Let's see, it's like minus 8 into 1. Okay? So minus eight cube root is minus 2, and then 1 cube root is 1 raised to the power 1 by 3, and this is 1 omega square. 3 values of power. If you put 1, you'll get this one, omega will get this one, and omega square will get this one. From here, you get 3 values. Okay, and then you have to take 1 on this side, so you'll get this one. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this one. What is the complex number that will satisfy this equation?
I.
Not I. I square is minus 1. And then I, right? Left hand side will be I.
Yeah, sorry.
Omega, right? Cube root of unity, 1 plus omega square equal to 1, equal to 0. Okay.
Yeah.
Omega will satisfy this one. So for that particular value of z, let me see what is the value of this one. From the second element, I'll be able to select the option. Omega is one of the z that will satisfy this one. So I'll put omega in this one. Okay.
Okay.
And the value should match with one of them.
So I'm getting A.
No. But the method is same or different?
Same. I did some calculation here, I guess.
If you are getting these values, then you should not get it wrong. Minus 1, minus 1, and 2. The first three terms. Are you getting these numbers minus 1, minus 1? and two
yes, sir.
For the first three. So then the fourth one is same as the first one because omega cube is 1. And the fifth term is same as the second term, and the sixth term is same as the third term. We just have to double it. Okay, so 1 plus 1 plus 4, it is 6. 6 into 2 is 12. The answer is 12.
Okay, I did some silly calculation mistake.
Yeah, fourth term is same as the first term. And 1 by omega is omega square. For that, you have to multiply by omega square numerator and denominator, and omega cube is 1. Okay, here you have to multiply by omega, and omega cube is 1. So that is why 1 by omega square is omega. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
This one.
Oh my God.
You should not expand as a summation. You just have to realize the complex number as a point in the space and see how the point is changing. Visualize this summation as one of the terms as one point in this plane. K equal to 1, it is 2 pi by 11, right? So it is here. Similarly, and the value of this thing is 1. So all the points lie in a circle of radius 1. And the second one will be here. So think in terms of points. If I add all these things, what I will get? If you have three vectors separated symmetrically, then the sum of those three forces is 0, right?
Yeah.
So use that idea here. So just so 1 to 10 is how many terms are there? K equal to 1 to 10, right? How many terms are there?
10.
And this is this whole angle should be 11 parts, right?
Yeah.
So you have to add that one part which is missing, that will make it 0, and then we subtract that part we are adding, so that will give the answer. And before that, this is not in cos plus I sine, right? It is sine plus I cos. The complex number if I'm representing as a point in the space, xy plane, then it is cos plus I sine theta, right?
Yeah.
But here it is sine plus I cos theta.
That's what I'm confused.
So what you do is you divide by I and multiply by I. I and I will cancel and this will become minus I. Okay. And that minus sign should not matter because e raised to the power minus I theta, and theta is changing from 1 to 2, this one. But here the direction will change. So that will not affect the answer. Okay, first when I divide by I, I'll get cos 2k pi by 11 minus I sine 2k pi by 11, and let that I sine be separately outside. And this is a summation, right? Even if I this is k equal to 1 to 10, right? So I'll make it 0 to 10 minus the 0 to 10. So if you put k equal to 0, cos 0 is 1, right? So it'll become minus 1. And this whole thing is inside. I is outside of this one. Okay. So this is now a set of complex numbers which are separated by 2 pi by 11. But this minus sign means, okay, if you assume with plus sign, it will be here. When I put the minus, it will be conjugate, so it will jump here. Okay, so sum of this thing is 0. Okay, basically, there are complex number 1, 2, which should form a full circle. When I take conjugates, one will come here, one conjugate, and two will come here, two conjugate. The conjugates should also be separated with the same equal angle of 2π/11. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So that sum is also zero. So this is conjugate of cos plus I sin. Okay. So that sum is also zero. The answer to this question is D. So there are two important steps here. One is this one, dividing by I and multiplying by I to get in this cos plus I sin form. After that, you have to go from 0 to 10 to cover the full circle. So since 0 is not there, I'm adding that term and then subtracting that term. Okay. And the third thing to realize is the sum of nth roots and the sum of conjugates of those n roots, both will add to 0. Okay.
Okay.
It's like saying here it is 11, right?
Yeah.
So it is like 1 plus z plus z square plus so on up to z raised to the power 10 plus 0, where z is the 11th root of this 1. Okay, so this means that I can take conjugate on both the sides. So z bar plus z bar square plus so on up to z bar raised to the power 10 is also 0. Got it?
Yes, sir.
First one is true. I take conjugate on both the sides. So this is also true. And this 1 plus z plus z, that is the 11th root of the 1. And what we have here is conjugate. The sum of those conjugate from 0 to 10 is also 0. Right? And we have taken 1 I outside, and there is 1 minus sign here. So the answer is minus I. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. I'll try this one. Here omega is not cube root of 1, it's something different, okay? X, Y, Z are complex numbers. A, B, C are also complex numbers. So how will you proceed? First step is important.
So no idea.
Mod x square, see, whenever mod square is there, whenever mod is there, try to use conjugate.
Okay.
It's easy for manipulating. Okay. And x is a plus b plus c. And what is x conjugate? What is x conjugate in terms of a, b, c? It will get distributed, right? It is a plus b plus c full conjugate, and the conjugate will be distributed. Okay, so this you can open up now. It will be a bar, that is mod a square plus mod b square plus mod c square. Because when I add X mod x plus mod y square plus mod z square, I should get the denominator. The node will cancel. Okay, so here that is happening. Mod z square plus the cross terms. Totally there will be 9 terms, right?
Yeah.
Back and then this B bar this B C bar and then C B bar. Okay, similarly y mod y square, everything should cancel because I'm going to add it. So x bar square, y bar square and z bar square. So it should, and omega is not so try this way and simplify it. Okay, omega is being given as e raised to the power I pi by 3, right? And pi by 3 is how much? 60 degrees. So that is equal to cos,
yeah.
60, half. Cos 60 is half plus I sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Okay, so omega is 1 plus I root 3 by 2 and omega
okay.
Is 1 minus I root 3 by 2. So all those things if you put, and omega square is e raised to I.
Okay.
2 pi by 3. That is 120. That means this is 60, right? So it will be minus half. Plus I root 3 by 2. Is it clear?
Okay.
Right, so all these things you have to use. Omega square is this one. Right. Yeah, that's what he has done. Mod x bar square is. Listen to conjugate and then you get this one. Okay. And similarly, mod y bar square, you'll get this one. Okay. And mod z square is this one. Okay. So when you add these things, so these terms are cancelling. This one. Plus this one, plus this one, they are cancelling. Okay, and then you are getting 3 times mod a square plus mod b square plus mod c square. Okay, so you just have to use these two. For omega square, this one, for omega, that one, and omega square, this one, and see that these things are cancelling.
Okay.
And important thing is you should get a square, b square, c square here. This is what he's getting there, no? Here I should get a square plus b square plus c square. A square will get a b a bar is a square. And then b mod b square is there. And then omega into omega bar. omega to omega bar, which is 1, right? If omega is e raised to the power I theta, omega bar will be e raised to the power minus I theta, right? So if you multiply it with r square, and the r is 1 here for omega. Okay, it is 1, right? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So omega to omega bar is 1, and c square, we will get omega square into its conjugate. Yeah. Any complex number, its conjugate will be r square, and r is 1 here, so it is 1 here. Plus the cross terms. Okay. Similarly, mod z square also will have this a square, b square, c square, and then the cross terms. So if you use these two for those things, for omega this one and for omega square this one. Okay. So instead of writing omega and omega like this, you can use this one. This will be convenient for manipulations. E is for I can take e to minus 2 pi by 3. Okay. That'll be easy to manipulate because it's all multiplying, no? Got it? All the cross terms are multiplying omega like that, right? It's all multiplying. For example, if you take AB bar, AB bar omega square is there, and then here AB bar omega is there. So 1 plus omega square should be 0. But that is AB bar here is 1. And the AB bar here is omega square, and AB bar here is omega. But 1 plus omega square is 1, 0, right? If you add these two, this will cancel. No, that is not true. There is 2 for cube root of unity. But here omega is I pi by 3. Or is this a mistake here? Okay, let me check the other one. But you cannot combine AB bar and A bar B, right? That cannot be combined.
Yeah. That's right.
A B bar and then B bar A omega is there. B A bar omega. A bar is 1. B A bar omega. And then B A bar omega square. Again, we have 1 plus omega square. So I'm just guessing this could be wrong. It should be a
question is wrong.
Wrong in the sense here, it should be 2 pi by 3.
Yeah.
If it is 2 pi by 3, it will cancel peacefully. Right, just leave it at this. Okay. So now this is the key step. Mod, whenever mod is there, just write in terms of conjugate. It's easy to manipulate. Okay, try this one.
Sir, minus 1.
That is a complex number. Imaginary part is non-zero. So, then do not take a value. 1 plus z plus z square. How do you get minus 1?
Sir, it cannot be negative in any case.
Why it cannot be negative?
Because there is
okay, z is x plus iy, and the condition is y not equal to 0.
Yeah,
okay, and or you can say r into e raised to the power I theta, theta not equal to pi by 2. Comma minus 5. Okay, so z square theta not equal to zero, then it becomes pure real, right?
Yeah.
Theta not equal to zero and pi. Okay, so z square is r square, e raised to the power 2 by theta. In the value, you cannot take the value. So theta not equal to zero, right? So if you put theta equal to zero, the value which I'll get, that should not happen to A. That's right, no? So if you put theta equal to zero, so it is R square plus cos zero is zero, right? So A is not equal to this one. And A is also not equal to the same thing, right? If you put pi, here is the I pi is minus one. So A is not equal to R square. If you put pi, it will be 2 pi. Here is equal to 2 pi, so it is 1 minus R plus 1. Okay. So there is no restriction on R. So if R equal to 1, so A is not equal to 1. Okay, we are missing a main big point. No, there is a complexness that remains by 0 and is real. A, this thing we have to use, right? A is z square plus this one is real. So, what does that mean? Okay, is written like this, since it is imaginary, it must be less than zero. Right, so this thing is equal to A, right? So he has written derivative like this. Okay, and the condition is Z cannot be purely real. Z has got an imaginary part, no? Okay, so suppose I treat this as a quadratic equation in Z. Then this root should not be real. There should not be any real roots of this equation. That means that Z is purely real. So that gives this condition. Discriminant should be negative. You will get this one. So A has to be less than 3 by 4. Okay, fine. Match the columns of column 1, students of column 1, with the interval 7, column 2. Okay, this is basically simple visualization. So, this complex number, the set real of, it is a complex number, mod z equal to 1, then not equal to plus or minus 1. That's right.
Yeah.
Okay, so real of 2yz divided by 1 minus z square under this condition. So real part of this one is, again you have to use conjugate, is equal to 2yz divided by 1 minus z square plus conjugate of this one, 2, conjugate of I is 1 into z bar divided by 1 minus z square conjugate. Whole thing divided by 2. Real part of complex number is z plus z bar by 2, right? Real part of z is z plus z bar divided by 2. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So this will be easy to manipulate. Okay, here in this function, how will you find domain of this function? Do you remember what is domain?
Yeah, the values that we can input.
Values, which one?
That we can input, like values of x.
Yeah, so the values of x it can take. So how will you, is there any restriction on the value of x from this equation?
Yes, sir.
What is the restriction on x?
It can't be
Is there any restriction on this value? Is there any restriction on this one?
Yes.
What is the restriction?
It can't be complex.
No. Sine inverse of something, right? So it should vary from minus 1 to plus 1.
Yeah.
So it is greater than minus 1 and less than plus 1. So, and there is a x thing here. So that will put a restriction on the value of x. Okay.
Yeah.
And that will match with one of the intervals here. Okay.
Yeah.
Try this one. And C is a determinant.
Sir, B, right?
For which one?
For B.
For B, what?
Answer is P or X.
I don't know. How do you answer so quickly? Okay, fine. That you can find out. Determinant. Okay, fine. You will say, I don't know. What about this one? D part. F of equal to this one. X greater than 0. Then X is increasing in. You can use wavy curve method.
Yeah.
So, what are the roots?
10 by 3 and 0.
Yeah. And between f dash x and f dash x equal to 0, if you put, you'll get x equal to 2.
Okay.
So beyond this point, it is not going straight like this. It is positive, that is fine, but it's going something like this and then going up. Okay.
Okay.
This is the point 2. Right. So this wavy curve method will not work. You just have to find f dash x and put that equal to 0. Okay. That will give the minimum point. After that, it is basically increase means f dash x should always be positive. Right? When it is increasing, the slope is always positive, right?
Yes, sir.
And the slope is f dash x. So from this, you get f dash x as a function of x, and that should be greater than 0. That is true for x greater than 2. Greater than or equal to 2.
Okay, sir.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, you want to close now?
Okay, sir.
Okay. See you on Monday then.
See you, sir.
Bye.